Hi, I'm Erika, one of the senior curriculum managers here at Magoosh and a GMAT expert. And in today's video, we're going to talk about another GMAT word problem. Now, if you've watched my video on the 6 hardest GMAT math problems, you know that statistics is a concept that a lot of GMAT test takers struggle with. And that's mostly because there are so many fun variations on basic statistical concepts that make them not so basic anymore. So that might be working with consecutive integers in a set, that might be working with tricky weighted average problems, or that might be working with things like min-max. Now, if you want to check out a really cool video on a strategy for weighted average problems, I recommend checking out Chris's video on the subject. But in today's video, we're going to talk about min-maxing, specifically in the context of word problems. So min-max problems are always going to be centered around our basic statistical definition. So that's going to be mean or average, it's going to be median, that's going to be range, that's going to be mode. So hopefully our definitions for those are rock solid. So the trickiness of min-max problems is that they take one of those statistical definitions and then they build a scenario or a set around it, and then they pick one or several of the numbers in there and they say they want to either minimize it or maximize it. So they either want to make it as small as possible or as large as possible. And then it's up to us to figure out how to manipulate the other numbers within that statistical definition, within that set, in order to make that happen. So if we want to minimize one number, do we want to maximize the other numbers, or do we want to minimize them as well? If we want to maximize one number, do we want to do what to these other numbers? So these problems require kind of a logical approach to this specific scenario, to this specific statistical definition, to the specific question that they're asking. So with that in mind, let's go ahead and try a GMAT min-max problem from Magoosh. All right, let's start by addressing the elephant on the slide, which is that this is not really a word problem. Yeah, I mean, sure, it has words, but it doesn't really have a scenario that we'd come to expect from a classic GMAT word problem. Now, I picked this problem because we showed it in our 6 hardest GMAT math problems video, but also because this problem could really easily be turned into a word problem. So that's something we're gonna explore after we work through the problem itself. So starting from the top, the average. Okay, so we know that we're working with an average here, so we know we're working with the average formula, which as a reminder is sum over number equals average. So the sum of the terms over the number of the terms equals the average of the terms. Okay, so we have the average of 4 different integers is 75. So working with this average equation, I'm going to go ahead and say my 4 different integers are A, B, C, and D, just to represent them for now. Okay, so the sum of the 4 different integers would be A plus B plus C plus D. Right? The number we know from the question stem is 4, A, B, C, and D, and the average is 75. Okay, great, I can work with that. Now, I could keep going with the question stem at this point, but what I'm gonna do first is I'm actually gonna manipulate this a little bit by multiplying by 4 or the number on both sides. And that's just gonna get rid of my fraction and make this a little bit easier to look at, to conceptualize, and to work with. So multiplying by 4 on both sides gives me A plus B plus C plus D equals 300. Continuing, if the largest integer is 90. Okay, so we've got some max language with largest, so that's gonna be important to note. I'm gonna go ahead and decide that my largest integer is D, and I'm just gonna put in 90 for it. Okay, so because this is the largest integer, I know that A, B, and C are not going to be larger than 90. Great, that's important information. Moving on. What is the least possible value of the smallest integer? Okay, so now I'm seeing some min language here. So I am looking to minimize the smallest integer. So I'm gonna go ahead and decide that that's A. Now, what does that mean for B and C if I want to minimize A? Well, thinking about this logically, I know that the sum is 300. So that means if A is going to go down, then B and C are going to have to come up an equal amount. So if I want to bring A down as far as it'll possibly go, make it the least, minimize it, that means I'm going to have to bring B and C up as far as they will go. So I want them to be the most that they can be, the largest they can be, the maximum they can be. All right. So what does that make B and C? Well, if we were missing one of the words in this question, we would go, okay, 90 is the largest possible integer in this set of numbers. So that means B and C should also be 90, which would lead to one of our wrong answers. But there's actually a word in here that prevents that from being the case, and that is this word, different. And this is a really important word in GMAT math problems, especially when we're dealing with min-max problems like this, because it means that B and C can't be 90 because we already have a 90. So what does that mean? Well, if we want C to be as big as possible, but not 90 and not larger than 90, that makes it 89. Okay, well then what does that make B? Well, B again has to be a different number, as large as possible, but not larger than 90. So it can't be 90, it can't be 89, so that makes it 88. Now we can manipulate and solve. All right, adding these numbers up, the trick that I'm gonna use is to add together three 90s and then subtract three, and that's going to give me A plus 267. All right, equals 300. And then I'm gonna subtract 267 from both sides, and that gives me A equals 33, or E. Now, notice here, if we had put in 90s for B and C, we would have gotten answer choice D, and then these other problems are gonna have to do with more of a misunderstanding of the problem. So in order to get this problem right, we had to have an understanding of basic statistical concepts. We had to be able to think logically about minimizing and maximizing. So if we are minimizing one value, we are likely maximizing other values. And then we had to read really, really, really carefully to make sure we didn't miss any critical information in the question stem. Now, like I mentioned earlier, this question could really easily be rewritten as a scenario-driven word problem while retaining the exact same numbers and the exact same method to solve. So looking at this one, my immediate kind of go-to is test scores. So I would rewrite this problem by saying that there is a student who is in a college class in which there are four equally weighted tests. Four equally weighted tests on which they want to receive an average test score of 75. Maybe that's like a requirement for a scholarship or a requirement for passing the class or for achieving their major, whatever. They want an average of 75. Now, maybe we know that they scored a 90 on their highest exam, and we know that they scored different, but lower scores on their other exams. And we wanna know what is the worst they can do on their fourth and final exam. So what is the least possible score that they can receive on their last exam? So really easily translated into this word problem. Now, of course, test scores aren't the only possible approach here. These could be scores in a game or prices of an item or weights of boxes, or really a ton of different things. But what we are going to see is we're going to see that statistical term like average. We are going to see that min-max language like most or highest or least or worst or smallest, that sort of extreme language. And we're going to see those numbers that we can fill in our equation with. So min-max problems are going to have the exact same approach. All we need to do is be able to recognize it, whether in a more standard numerical form like this problem or in a scenario-driven word problem. Now, if you haven't watched our other videos on GMAT word problems, there are two of them that we put out recently on overlapping sets and work rate, so I highly recommend you check those out, especially if you struggle with highly specific word problem types. If this video helped you, let us know by liking and subscribe for more videos from me and the other experts here at Magoosh. And if you have requests for future videos or for specific word problem types that you want to work through, leave those in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you later.